in Chicago's suburbs are taking steps to try to discourage students from vaping.
The measures come and amid rising rates of illnesses linked to vaping, including one death in Illinois. That might be the first of its kind in the country. WGN's Dana Rebeck is live in Hoffman Estates with more on that. Hi, Dana.
Hi, well, Conan High School here behind me is just one of the schools in the suburbs that has been heavily involved in discouraging vaping use among students. U.S. Congressman Roger Krishnamoorthy's son is a student here. His father is now also at the head of a probe into vaping use related to lung illnesses.
20% of high school students are vaping and 5% of middle school students are vaping. That is horrendous.
U.S. Congressman Raja Krishnamoorthy is now leading the charge, launching a federal investigation into the national vaping epidemic.
We were very distressed to learn on Friday the first death linked to vaping, and this person happened to be an Illinoisan.
Numbers of vaping-related illnesses in Illinois are disproportionately higher than other states. With nearly 200 cases reported nationwide, there are 22 confirmed cases in Illinois, with another 12 under investigation.
The common link between all these cases right now is the vaping, the history of recent vaping. So we urge people to use caution and consider avoiding the use of such material.
High schools in the Chicago suburbs are doing their part to discourage vaping among students. Conant High School in Hoffman Estates taking exterior doors off the entrances to bathrooms in the school. They also installed vaping sensors in bathrooms, but later removed them due to false alarms. Similar sensors have been installed at Hinsdale Central and South High Schools, as well as Evanston Township.
These kids are going to pay a heavy price for this addiction.
U.S. Senator Dick Durbin has been pushing the head of the FDA to crack down on e-cigarette companies like Juul and how they market their products.
He has the power today to ban the flavorings that are so attractive to children in high school and middle school, and he refuses to do it.
Last year, e-cigarette use among youth spiked 78% from the year before, lawmakers wanting answers and to protect children from harm.
This is a public health epidemic and crisis, and we are not going to let up until we end it.
Students at Hinsdale Central and South High Schools, if caught vaping, also have to take a 3-hour online intervention course. Other schools have signs about the risks posted in bathrooms and also post that information on screensavers on computers in the school. Live in Hoffman Estates, Dana Rebeck, WGN News.